all about. Don't beat the beats, fuck the rhymes and cut. Now what? Don't what it's all about. Don't beat the beats, fuck the rhymes and cut. What? Don't what it's all about. Don't beat the beats, fuck the rhymes and cut. What it's all about. Don't beat the beats, fuck the rhymes and cut.
So it needs no explanation. Everybody is a protege. Dope to play today, but tomorrow gets blown away. Our leaks are better than the cuts off your album. Upset because you know it's true, discussing your outcome.
Cool, so this is Ryan from Hip Hop Kings, speaking with Koncept and Soul Khan. How's it going, guys?
Amazing.
Incredible.
Excellent. So you're here as part of a UK tour.
Yes.
How did this originally come about?
This came about, actually the introduction was made through a connection between you and Scott French, aka Truth, fantastic rapper, fantastic battler.
Fantastic person.
Fantastic musician in general, shout out to him. And it developed into something where I and Koncept would come for five blessed dates. And it was going to possibly get extended to the rest of Europe, but this time it didn't seem like it was in the cards, and we'll see in the future.
And it was too soon, and we figured it'd be better. We figured do the five dates,
yeah,
tear it down,
come back and smash it again,
and many more.
Smashingly. And that's why we're here today on the King's English Tour, on the last date of it. I don't want to call it a mini tour. I don't want people to say,
we're here with the Hip Hop Kings right now.
Hip Hop Kings killing the game. So everything is very synergistically aligned. Synergy is a terrible word that corporate people in the States used.
That's beautiful to me. Yeah. So for the fans who may not be aware, how about an introduction to the Brown Bag AllStars?
No problem. Well, this is J57.
We're
J57 to be here, you would see an Italian gentleman who with a heart of gold that makes incredible beats and is a damn great rapper.
And then you would see the audible doctor who loves Burger King.
Loves
and,
it.
And he eats way too much of it. And an incredible producer and an incredible rapper as well.
And in the middle here, you might see DJ Element sort of like peeking underneath women's skirts. As
drinking like dry martinis. Yeah,
making dope beats and he's a great turntablist. DJ Ihala would be hanging from the rafters with one arm like Method Man, just swinging back and forth in basketball shorts.
Screaming.
Something. Yeah, and he's a dope DJ. Yeah. Also DJs for Boot Camp, Click, Duck Down,
Torre.
And this is Koncept. Koncept is an energetic beast of a rapper and lyricist who only wears the finest of five panel hats.
And also does parkour.
Parkour all the time, all the damn time.
I actually, during my set, I'm gonna do a gainer.
Yeah.
Which is a backflip, a forward backflip.
Yes.
While I rap. Never gonna stop rapping while I do it.
Yeah. And never gonna stop. He's gonna be perpetually. He's gonna take off and fly like this. It's gonna be so weird, man. You're gonna see nothing like it. That's what Americans can do. We believe in ourselves that much.
It's crazy.
It's Yankee ingenuity, as they call it. And I'm Soul Khan. I rap, and that's pretty much what I do. I sing.
And he gives no bargains at all.
No bargains. I will jam myself for anything. Actually, it's not true. I feel bad because we're out here and like as emissaries of American hip hop, I guess, to some degree. Not that there have never been such a thing here before, but I always feel like people like actually come up to me at the merch table. They're like, so how about if I get that and that? Can I get a deal? And I'm like, nope. Like, I feel like we're living.
He touched his nose if you didn't get that.
It's like a little stereotype thing. It's a cool learning experience, which it's been a dope learning experience out here because we don't also, until you come out here, there's no amount of research you can do to tell you what it's going to be like in all its details and specifics. Every town is different, every city's different, every person's different, you know. It's funny, like, I came out here thinking, like, yo, I'm gonna kill these t-shirts, everyone's gonna buy, like, 50 of them, bring them home on their shoulders, and give them out to everyone in the town square. And the thing is, like, it wasn't, you know, and, like, people have been buying shirts, but, like, more so, people are, like, really hungry for CDs. And Ipswich bought all of my CDs, like every single CD I bought in one night.
And these as well.
Yeah, they're buying these. He brought mad more CDs than I did, but then again, I'm Mr. Digital Guy because I'm that 21st century with it. So, not that he isn't as well. He's on iTunes, obviously. Shout out to Awaken, his debut solo commercially sold album.
to make sure it's not upside down. Good. Okay.
I've done that before.
Go get it.
Yeah, it's dope.
The worst is when I walk around and I go to stick a sticker up somewhere and I stick it upside down. I'm like,
you're forever fucked. But then they have to look at it like, what does that say?
Yeah, but then it's like,
now you Don Draper.
I can't even say concept backwards, so yeah, I'm not gonna try.
So speaking of the solo projects, concept, obviously you've got Awaken. What was your favorite personal track from the project?
It's a difficult question.
Aspirations and the other thing.
Yeah, I guess Aspirations. Save Me is probably my personal favorite, I guess, if I could really have a favorite to my own album. I guess it's the song that's like the deepest to me. I talk about things that are very personal to me, like, you know, my dad passing away and my family life and et cetera, et cetera. So that track really hits home to me. And some of the things that I say on the song I probably haven't even said out loud. Some of the things that I talk about with my stepdad and et cetera, et cetera. So yeah, I'd have to say that song. And actually, I get a lot of people saying that that's their favorite song from the album.
Dope song.
And if not that one, Aspirations, which is like the...
I guess like the lead.
No, but it is. That would be like my second.
That's nice.
That was actually the second single. The first single was Watch the Sky Fall, which features Royce da 5'9", and is produced by Marco Polo, which is also on Wax. You can go get the Wax, Watch the Sky Fall EP.
It's made of wax.
The Aspirations video is actually in rotation on MTVU right now.
Brown Bag, stay on
there.
Make
sure you go watch that. And that answers that question.
I don't know if they get MTV. Do you guys get MTV too?
Online.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah. Damn, well, you can watch it on YouTube as well.
Yeah, all up on YouTube. The demise of cultural integrity, YouTube.
So, Khan, what projects are you working on? What can fans expect for you from this year?
I personally think they will be able to expect that I prove that I am the absolute best rapper under 30 years old in 2012. And if they disagree, outside of my crew and family, obviously, I don't try to compete against them in that regard because that'd be douchey. They're the homies and we all work together and support each other. And I grow as a rapper because of them. But outside of Brown Bag and my immediate team, like Scene and folks like that, I'm gonna fucking destroy everybody because I don't think that a lot of people have the determination or concern for the listener to provide music that will endure for them. They should check out a project I just dropped for free, an EP called Wellstone on djbooth.net.
Yep.
And if you could find shit realer in terms of messages with a good medium than that, you're lying to yourself.
And the beats are banging also. DJ Element produced the whole thing.
Yeah, and that's again, you know, like, it goes to what Concept was saying, you know, Brown Bag is such a strong self-contained unit that we don't, my initial thought when I approach a project isn't, who am I gonna work with? Because I already know. I know it's gonna be Brown Bag. My first, you know, I dropped an album in 2010 November called Soul Like Khan, produced entirely by Brown Bag or Brown Bag affiliated producers. And that was for free though. So my first commercially available full debut album, untitled as yet, is gonna be produced entirely by J57, except for one track, the first one. Everything else is J57 orchestrated. It's sample free, and it's hopefully going to change the way people think about the dimensions and possibilities of sample free hip hop, because
it will.
It will. Thank you for the extra boost there. Yeah. It will. Honestly, there's a lot of sample-free hip-hop that's very big and empty and sterile. So I'd like to make sample-free hip-hop that has some guts and some heart in it.
You won't, like, listening to it, you won't even realize that it's, like, sample-free.
And when you do realize it's sample-free, the things you could tell are samples. They're going to sound so dope. J57's a sample-free beast. If you haven't heard any of the sample-free stuff, that sounds so weird, right? That's so weird. This beast is made of no samples.
He's actually a gargoyle.
He's a gargoyle. all the sedimentary material he is made out of is just pure, you know. J57 is a pretty one of a kind producer, and you know, he's been working with me since Brown Bag has been Brown Bag. So
yep.
And you know, this is an album we've been thinking about.
Brown
for
Bag
a long time.
Since Brown Bag.
Yeah. And as we always say, there's no I in Brown Bag, so it's a team effort. Every time out the gate, but definitely people should get Wellstone. It is, I swear, if you want, and all, you know, I have other EPs too, Pursuance, Resolution, Acknowledgement, all available at my website, soulcom.com/music, if you want me to give you that much of a lead-in. And it's just music that should grab you and move you to do something or feel some way. That's the thing that I want to make music for. If you don't, it, Not to say all music has to be deep and meaningful and content driven, but there needs to be some. Right now, there's not that much. Even the people who say something now, a lot of it is just very self-indulgent, like, yo, so hard being famous, it's so tough right now, I don't know which Aston Martin to pick today. Like, dude, come on, really? Like, that's not, those aren't real problems. Like, those, you know, that's the thing. I just want people to ultimately feel compelled by music that we make.
Well, straight up, we love doing this, and when you listen to our music, you could hear that love, and you could hear that passion, and it comes through, and all the energy, and everything that we do.
But, like, I personally, I don't make music for myself at all. If no one was listening to my music, I wouldn't make music. Straight up, I'd stop. If I was, like, convinced that there was no future to this, or route, or path to this, I'd do something else. I'd only do this for audiences, period. And the day that that dries up is the day that I'm like, all right, thanks for everything you've given me, peace out. But I think we'll be able to sustain this for a minute.
So speaking of the audiences, you've obviously entered previously a career in the rap battle world as well. There is a stigma attached to the fact that battle rappers can't make music.
Yeah.
How have you overcome that? Because quite clearly, you're part of a group that can. Mm-hmm. You can sell records. How did you tackle the problems in being associated specifically with a battle rapper?
I quit. That's what I did.
Wow!
It's the only thing you can do in America. In the UK, it's different. I see it, the possibilities where people are willing to be broad and open-minded enough to say, oh, this person's a battle rapper, but here's their music and I'll support both. And ultimately, I'd imagine someone who's successful enough in music would just segue out of battle rap, you know, eventually, you know, like if they're trying to maintain both. I think it's possible here. It's possible in Australia, possible in Canada. Possible virtually everywhere except for America. And there are rappers to blame for it, you know? Like, and it's not my fault that they couldn't, you know? Even rappers who, if they sold those numbers that they did now, battle rappers, they sold those numbers they did now, they'd be legends and hailed as successes. But back then, given the resources put into them, it was a flop. So, like, it sucks because it's not my fault that people feel this way. And it's such a deep psychological stigma that if you go to America and you're a battle rapper who makes good music, someone will come to you and say, yo, I'll give you a better example. On Twitter, someone will hit me up and they'll say, yo man, when are you gonna battle again? And I'll say, I don't. And they'll say, oh, okay. And I say, yeah, but I make music that you should listen to. You know, a lot of other people bought it and listened to it as well. And they're like, okay, well, good luck. Like, it shuts off in their head. They're not like, and I got the analytics and numbers to prove that the turnover from music or from battling to music is just so low that it's not worth it for me to keep doing it. But I appreciate the fans that it did get me. I appreciate the notoriety and like name recognition it gave me. But I also don't want it to saddle me with that weight forever, nor my crew, you know? So, had to quit that, I'm sorry. I did what I could. I gave y'all more than 20 battles in the span of 2 years.
And we're working on a lot of stuff right now, and that takes a lot of time. Solo, group, everything, so.
And also, battling only goes so far, only satisfies so many emotional needs. Like, it's braggadocious or insulting. Like, that's so one-dimensional, really. Oh, two-dimensional, I just stated two-dimensional, so it's literally two-dimensional. So why keep doing that if you want to do something greater? You know, a lot of people have, like, battling will exist and can exist and can thrive and grow and it's dope. But it's not going to be a central pillar of hip-hop culture. It just won't. I'm not trying to be cynical, I'm just saying because of the emotional nature of it and what its aims are, it cannot be. So shout out to Ur for doing it so incredibly well and Don't Flop for doing it with a medium that is so kind of like, it's a repetitive medium. It's like, you suck. No, you suck. I fucked your mom. No, I fucked your mom. And my own mom, just to show you I can fuck her first, and that's gross, you know, like that's...
And your grandmother is ugly.
Yeah, exactly. Great. You know, or I'd shoot everyone. Like, that's all you can do with it. But anyway, I digress.
Yo, shout out to Brown Bag AllStars. Next time, hopefully we'll all be out here. Shout out to you for all the support. Shout out to all of England that we've rocked so far. The crowds have been amazing. The people have been amazing.
The people that traveled from other towns and cities to go to the shows. People who drove. There were commuters in every single city.
No, it's literally been incredible. We've had a great time, and we hope to be back very soon.
Oh, and shout out to everybody who has been so hospitable to help us along the way, whether it's with accommodations. whether it's accommodations, because, you know, whether it's accommodations or just like, even if you're someone who just bought us a drink while we were chilling at the merchandise table, every bit of support always helps and it means a lot. Shout out to Hip Hop Kings. Live the lifestyle.
Blah!